Ramchandra Pandurang Tope, also known as Tatya Tope, was an Indian leader in the Indian Rebellion of 1857. Born in village Yawla in Maharashtra, he was the only son of Panduranga Rao Tope and his wife Rukmabai, an important noble at the court of the Maratha Peshwa Bajirao II. His father shifted his family with the Peshwas to Vithur, where his son became the most intimate friend of the Peshwa's adopted son Nana Dondu Pant, known as Nana Sahib and Maharaj Madhav Singh. In 1851, when Lord Dalhousie deprived Nana Sahib of his father's pension, Tatya Tope also became a sworn enemy of the British.
हिंदुस्तान में फैल जाएगी।
लेकिन तात्या
कब तक सोचते रहेंगे नाना साहब? यही मौका है, इस बार या उस बार।
महारानी लक्ष्मीबाई की जय हो।
विराजी है तात्या।
वक्त आ गया है, सोचा था उससे पहले।
हाँ, इसी पल का तो 100 साल से इंतजार था।
हम तो बस नाम के शहंशाह हैं, और हम करें तो क्या करें।
तूफानी लहर उठ रही है जापना, उसके साथ नहीं तैरे तो डूब जाएंगे।
In May 1857, when the political storm was gaining momentum, he won over the Indian troops of the East India Company stationed at Kanpur, established Nana Sahib's authority and became the commander-in-chief of his forces.
Thank you.
After losing Gwalior to the British, Tope launched a successful guerrilla campaign in the Sagar and Narmada regions and in Khandesh and Rajasthan. British forces failed to subdue him for over a year. Tope is considered a hero in India, writes Colonel G.B. Malleson eloquently in the Indian Mutiny of 1857. Tatya Tope was a marvelous guerrilla warrior.
Thank you.
pursuit of him, Brigadier Parkley had marched consequently 240 miles in 9 days, Brigadier Somerset 230 in 9 days and again 70 miles in 48 hours. Colonel Holmes through a sandy desert 54 miles in little over 24 hours. Brigadier Horner 145 miles in 4 days, yet he slipped through them all, through enemies watching every issue of the jungles in which he lay concealed.
This is the King's Highway, and I advise you and your men to make way.
On your right! Present!
Only to fall at the last through the treachery of a trusted friend. He was, however, betrayed into the hands of the British by his trusted friend Man Singh, chief of Narwar. While asleep in his camp in the Paran forest, he was defeated and captured on 7th April 1859 by British General Richard John Meristruth and taken to Shivpuri, where he was tried by a military court. Tope admitted the charges brought before him, saying that he was answerable to his master Peshwa alone. He was executed at the gallows on April 18, 1859. Tope is considered a hero in India, writes Colonel G.B. Malson eloquently in the Indian Mutiny of 1857. The British troops had pitched their tents on the parade ground near the fort of Shivpuri, 70 miles from Gwalior. The day was April 18, 1859. It was 4 o'clock in the afternoon. A smiling, charming prisoner was brought out of the prison. His hands and feet were chained. Under guard, he was taken to the hangman's post. He had been condemned to death. The prisoner stepped towards the post fearlessly. There was no hesitation as he stepped upon the platform. It was the custom to cover the eyes of the condemned man with a scarf. When the soldier stepped forward with the scarf, he smiled and made signs to say, "I don't need all this." Nor did he allow the hands and feet to be bound. He himself put the noose around his neck. The rope was tightened. Then at last there was a pull. In a moment it was all over. It was a heart-rending scene which moved the whole country to tears. The man who was hanging lifeless on the gallows of the English was no criminal. He was not a thief. He was no cutthroat. He was the supreme commander in the War of Indian Independence, which in 1857 had challenged the hold of the British over India. It was he who more than anybody else shook the mighty British Empire to its foundations. holding aloft the flag of freedom. He sought to break the chains of slavery and fought the military might of the English heroically. His name was Tatya Tope, a household word for bravery.